are spot on, not only on the marketing of, you know, your product itself, but your lead up to a new shirt coming out, a new print coming out, and hey, it's got limited time, then you do the countdown. But I think probably the most important part about your marketing is after I've bought something from you, you guys send a nice follow-up email, and it's like, if you're not 100% satisfied, send it back. You know, so you don't miss a beat. Where
Absolutely.
did you get so fucking good at marketing?
Oh man, you know what? As a consumer, I'm a pretty picky consumer, to be honest. I'm not. So Justin, my right hand man, he says I'm an easy sale. Like I love to be sold. You know, like if we walk into a car place, I'm probably not even gonna haggle with you if you're a great salesman. You know, it's just like I love to be sold, but I'm looking for that, like that quality and service and everything. And so I always am looking for new ways for us to do that. And I feel like there's even ways we'll, you know, there's a lot of ways we can improve. And now that, you know, now at our, that we're growing more, it's like it gives us more ability to do so. So when I see the sales increase, I always look at it as like, what else can we do for the customer to, you know, to get in touch with them more? What can we do to make sure that they know and trust us? And I think a lot of that really spawned for me in transparency because I felt like when we were selling a product that we didn't 100% make ourselves, it really I felt it was like something in the back of my mind that I never wanted to feel again. I wanted everyone to be able to see everything, and so that there's nothing ever to hide. So then that way, everyone could, you know, it's like you can come walk our warehouse and you're gonna see. And people have actually said this out loud, like, I can't believe this shit happens. Like, this is the stuff that I see on Instagram. Like, this is how it actually is, you know? Like, it's everything that I imagined it would be. And that's a great thing because when you can convey that through through a message, and your message turns into, let me tell you the truth, rather than, you know, twisting it in so many ways, then it becomes something organic. And I think that anything that's organic in business is just so worth pushing out there. So, and then from another standpoint, I used to work at Harley and so did Justin, and our jobs every day are just talking to people that are bummed, you know, and every day it's just like, you know, you get to the point where you're just beat down every day, and then they're like, this happened, and blah, 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 blah. And then what we wanted to do is, you know, I basically told them, I'm like, hey, if anything goes wrong with anything, button falls off, send them a new shirt. Don't, you know, do not inconvenience anyone time, do not inconvenience anyone money or, you know, anything like that. We need to make sure it's taken care of always. So no matter what, make sure that your guys' thought in the back of your mind is not cost. That's my job. I'll worry about the cost. You guys, what I will give you is that I promise you, I'll always make sure that there's enough money going through the company that you guys can replace this stuff and make sure that it is 100% satisfied always. You know, I was like, that is something that I think that in the end, it will pay back in spades.
Yeah.
You know, and so that's just been like our clear, you know, our clear way of wanting to do business the whole time. And I find it, you know, when I go home at night and I never think about any of that stuff. I only get to read messages about how stoked people are. And coming from an industry where I just read messages all day about how pissed everyone is, it's like, it's so enlightening, you know, it's just so lighthearted, and it makes you feel great, you know? And so to continue to do business that way, it just seems like the best way.
I think the best example of doing business that way, I mentioned before we went on the air, my brother runs In-N-Out Burger. And their philosophy is the customer's always right. And I worked there for a lot of years, had a nice early career there. But I remember people would walk in with like two bites left of their hamburger and they'd be like, this burger's raw. I can't eat it. And it's like, there's two bites there. Okay, no problem. We'll get you another one. You know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, your service is going to speak volumes and you're going to get more than enough customers to cover that cost of that one person trying to take advantage. And what I'm blown away by, Danny, is that you understand that so early in the life of your business. I mean, you haven't been around that long to make that your full-time philosophy and see that it's true based on the materials I get from you guys. So great job with that.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate that.
You know, another marketing question for you. I see you guys do these collaborations. You've got one with Thorogood USA. And I just, how ingenious, you've got a product that goes along with their product, but they're two separate companies. And I got to tell you, they're lucky to have you too, because I've been looking at their sites going, wow, I need a new pair of boots. Maybe I should pick up some of those,
right,
as opposed to something else. Right.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So early on, and I haven't said this publicly really, but just to be completely transparent, what I've said in my meetings with my staff, and I include my entire staff in a lot of this stuff, I do most of the marketing myself. It's between me and a couple of the guys that are in art, and then we do most of the design as well. But I always want them to know exactly what's going on, just so that, they could get stoked and hyped and know that they're, the company they're working for, so hard for, is that we're constantly moving forward, doing new and exciting things, and you really want to spread that, enthusiasm, through all facets of your business. And one thing that I told them, I was like, when we started with collaborations, I called it pirate marketing, basically. And I'm like, we can't afford marketing, but what we can do is we can make stuff for people that don't know how to make it.
Mm-hmm.
So what we're doing is we're pulling up to their ship just for a little while, and we jump in and we share all their customers. And, just as fast as we got there, we jump back on ours and we take off, mm-hmm, and we're on to the next one. And the great thing is that over the time that we've done that, now it's not so much pirate marketing. And now we're more of a two-way street. It's a highway, and we're using each other to, it's always a mutually beneficial relationship, where it's like, hey, now we have these companies hitting us up. They're like, hey, all the people buying our stuff are not young, so we need to use you.
Yeah.
And so we're like, hey, totally, we got you. Like, we'll pull this in. We know how to talk to these people, and we'll make it happen. And then in the end, your brand has been around forever. We've been using your products forever. So for one, we're extremely excited to do it. It's almost a pride deal. And then for two, like, you're basically putting your stamp of approval on our company. And so as a young company, you need those seals of approval. You wear those like badges of honor, because someone just, they solidified what you're doing and who you are with an industry giant in whatever industry that it is. And we really utilize those collabs to be able to go into a lot of different niches. And a lot of those niches are, you have to know them well. You have to know that customer base well. You need to know how to get into them, because they're just not like lowrider culture, for one, or hot rod stuff. Like, you can't just run in, and be like, hey, we're a new clothing company, because it happens every day.
Yeah.
We have to be able to like work our way in there, really grow with it, and try to show everyone like, this is what we're here to do, and we're going to bring more to you. We want to bring more and make sure that you're better off, that we're here, and we know for sure that we're going to be better off that you're with us, And I think that's another big point for a lot of businessmen these days, is that when you do business, and I'm sure that you know exactly what this is like, there's two different kinds of businessmen that you get in bed with over, mergers or over collaborations or anything like that. There's a guy that, you have no one that can tell you what good he's done for you, but it seems like he's done good off of everyone else.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have that guy that everybody in the past has told you, oh, that guy is phenomenal because he did this for me. That guy is phenomenal because he did this for me. And that business is still benefiting from them as well. However, they always make sure that those I's are dotted and those T's are crossed, and that the other side is making money as well. And that's how I've always tried to really go at it, that if we're going to do business with anyone, I want to make sure that I serve you as best as I can first, before I even think about my needs and my dollar or anything like that, because I know in the end it's going to work out. And that's how those mutually beneficial relationships just, they start to grow. And now our collaborations are just so amazing.
Yeah,
really bring the other brand a lot and bring us a lot, and it's just great. It's a great way of doing business.
No, I love it. I operate under delivering five times the value. Somebody pays me $20, I want to give them $100 back. And I love what you're doing. By the way, that's going to be my next flannel, that Thorogood, because if there's any left, because I know you guys sell out of this stuff. But I love the print. I love what you're doing, and you guys are jamming on it. One last business question, because I probably could talk to you all day because you're so fascinating. You guys have other merchandise, and this is the first time I'll say this publicly. I'm super loyal to brands, and my friend started Malcolm. He started Ithaca underwear years ago. He's no longer with the company.
Oh, yeah.
But you know, they have a phenomenal product, and I started buying your stuff, and then you guys came out with a little underwear ad. I'm like, all right, I'm going to give it a shot. You know, you did a great job, and I'm slowly switching over, and you know, Malcolm's not there anymore, so I don't feel bad, but you guys have all kinds of different types of merchandise. You know, I know how you did it because you've told me the last hour here, but why? And it's pretty bold to be jumping into socks and underwear. I think hats are a natural fit for you, but you're getting all over the place now.
Yeah. I mean, to be honest with you, it's just an extension of myself. I am so, so picky about underwear. And I've, you know, and so when you say, when you can, you know, compare us to Ithaca, I am, I'm honored by that. That's awesome. They make such a great product. But you know, I'm so picky with that kind of stuff that I'm just like, I feel like, and it's kind of funny because if you look at me, I have a pretty plain style. I just like what I like, you know, but when it comes to the functionality of those products, like I will not sell it unless we figure out how to make it better.
Yeah.
And that's why a lot of times, you know, people are like, hey, why don't you make this? And it's like, the reason why is because I might not know enough about it to make it better yet. Like, and if I do something, I want my business to be a reflection of solving problems. And if you can solve a problem with your merchandise, then you know that it's got to be a win if you can plug it into the right places. I mean, basically, you know, the formula of solve problem plus great marketing plus great service, it's going to be a winner every time.
Yeah.
You know, but you can't be lacking in any of the three. You know, but if you hit all three, it's slam dunk every time. So basically, when we got into underwear, and we've been working on it for a long time, and it's the same thing with socks. You know, the footbeds on the socks have to be a certain, you know, certain way. They have to breathe and everything. And I'm crazy about that stuff too. And I just try to make sure that we are always able to have enough of a financial foundation that we can dedicate the time to never putting something out prematurely,
mm-hmm.
you know, and taking that time to, you know, it takes us 2 years, 3 years to come up with the right underwear. Let's do it, you know, but it has to be right. And it can't go out with that name on it unless it gets there. And the thing is that today with e-commerce, that's your calling card right there. You know, it's like, they don't get to talk to me every day. They don't get to see me or, you know, or stand in front of me and shake my hand. I don't get to do a, you know, a sales thing on it or anything. What I have to really invest with them is their trust. And the only way for me to do that through an e-commerce solution is to be able to, you know, get them to buy the product and make sure that that product checks all the boxes for them and that they trust that after a little while, everything that they tried is kind of along the same quality and they haven't had any quality issues. And if they had, we'd take care of it, that they're not going to hesitate when something new comes out. And they know if something does come out that's new, it's going to be good.
Yeah,
it has to be good. And that's the way it seems like we could build, you know, from just flannels to, you know, like saying we don't even use blank T-shirts anymore. We created our own, like we create our own blanks for T-shirts. We create our own blanks for hoodies now, everything, so that we're never relying upon anybody else. And that every single product that comes out of here has our name on it. You know, that's the way it continues to go. And it's been, man, it's been a journey. It's incredible.
It really is, Danny. I mean, just learning your story. By the way, I'm going to vouch for those underwear. I'm 52, so I'm not going to let the band hang out of my jeans, you know, so everybody can see the brand, but it's there. Okay, I got it.
Yeah, totally.
Look, man, you've been so gracious with your time and your story. And, you know, I haven't had a lot of people on in the retail sector, and really it was great to hear how you got to where you're at. Just give us an idea. I don't need a number, but give us an idea of the volume you guys are doing now in a short period of time, because that warehouse you took over is big. And I've seen a lot of boxes in those pictures.
Yeah, I can tell you that we've doubled in sales every year the last five years. And that's been incredible. But this year, I got to tell you, I really didn't think it was going to be possible. And it was a big test of what we were made of. And, you know, I mean, at the beginning of this year, we were still operating with, there's eight of us, I think, total.
Mm-hmm.
And at the end of this year, as it's blown our minds, we've now reached to the point where we'll do over 20 million sales this year.
Wow.
Through e-commerce, I should say. So it's been incredible, and we have new problems now.
Yeah, you do.
You know, it's a whole new set of issues keeping up, you know, and in these last couple of years, it was, you know, it started turning into like, wow, like now we have to think about things differently and doing this and everything else. But